This video we're going to talk about two examples that will use the trigonometric techniques of integration to find the antiderivative. The first example will be the integral of tangent x multiplied by the secant cubed x dx. So if you use the u substitution for the tangent, you will be unlucky because the derivative will be secant square x. So you will have one more secant x that you will not know what to do with. If you use the secant square x as your u, the du will be secant x tan x. And that's exactly what you have. So you will have one more secant for the du allocated for that, right? So we can say that u is equal to secant x, right? The du is going to be secant x tan x, right? So now let's see what we're going to have. So we can write this as tan x secant square x dx, right? So this part, so we can write this as u squared du. Right, so u will be taken, u squared will be secant square x, and du is going to be tan x secant x dx, right? So now it's going to be easy, right? We just use the power rule of the antiderivative. So 1/3 u to the third plus a constant, putting the u in terms of the original, which is secant, we will get 1/3 secant cubed x plus a constant, okay? Now the second example is going to be different. It's going to be the integral of cosine square x times sine square x dx. Okay. So notice here that that basically you can use the half angle formula to rewrite this, right? For the cosine, you can write this as, I'm going to use the brackets, so you can write this as 1/2 times 1 plus cosine of 2x, and then for the sine square x, you can write 1 minus cosine of 2x. Okay, so that's the half angle formula. Then let's distribute that and simplify the integrand. So let's keep the 1/4 outside, because 1/2 squared is 1/4, and then we're going to just multiply these guys, 1 plus cosine 2x, 1 minus, so we'll have 1. And you know what? This is just 1 minus cosine squared 2x, right? That's all it does, because the middle two terms are canceled out. And now there's one more thing to point. So this, we're going to use the half angle formula for the cosine one more time, right? Because we have the squared. But the only difference is, watch out, there's a 2x now instead of just x. So that means we will have 1 minus 1/2 times 1 plus cosine 4x, right? Dx. Because we have cosine squared 2x, so that's why we will have 1 plus cosine 4x, right? Twice as what you have in the formula, what you would have had in the formula if this x was without the 2, if the coefficient was 1. But here the coefficient is 2, that's why we have to have the coefficient here in the half angle formula twice the normal coefficient 2 that you would have, let's say here. Okay, so let's see, that's going to give us this. And let's simplify the integrand a little bit. So let's see. So we're going to have the integral of 1/4. And then we're going to have 1 minus 1/2 minus 1/2 cosine of 4x dx. And that simplifies as, let's see. So that's 1/4 minus 1/8. Minus 1/8 cosine of 4x dx, right? 1/4 minus 1/8 is 1/8 precisely, so we'll have 1/8 x as the antiderivative, and then I'm just going to keep this because we're going to work this out. cosine of 4x dx. Okay, so if you use the u substitution, u is equal to 4x, the du is going to be equal to 4 dx, right? So you will have to divide the integral by 4, so multiply it by 1/4, in other words, to compensate for the pop-up of 4 in the du. So 1/8x minus 1/4 times 1/8, because there's a 1/8 that we can put outside, cosine u du. Du. Okay, so then we will have 1/8x minus 1/32 sine u plus a constant, because the antiderivative cosine is sine, right? And then putting everything back in terms of x, we're going to have 1/8x minus 1/32 sine of 4x, right? Because u is equal to 4x, so sine of 4x plus a constant. So there goes your antiderivative to this problem. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next one.